This research team is involved in a catch, tag, and release program involving a fish that's widely feared for being an ocean predator. But these scientists say sharks are an important part to Gulf Coast waters.
9-4.
In the past year, these researchers have studied all kinds of sharks as part of a long-term monitoring program at the University of Southern Mississippi's Gulf Coast Research Lab. They are taking inventory, one fish at a time, and recording information such as where large populations of shark are living, along with their health and reproductive habits.
Those are really important components that need to go into a stock assessment to make sure that their populations are maintained, and in turn, help maintain the populations of those other species that our fisheries are relying on.
The group takes day-long expeditions to the deepest waters of the Gulf to longline for larger sharks.
We may average, we may get 20 sharks per set. Everything that comes up, we tag and release for future work so we can look at tag recapture. We have fishermen that turn them back in and, in case we ever recatch them, we know, about what the population is and what they're doing.
Hendon says their research project relies heavily on citizen scientists to be successful.
The commercial fishermen, the recreational fishermen, if they're aware and they recapture a fish with our tag in it, we love it when they give us a call. We provide them with a recapture report, giving them a map of where their fish moved. So it's really trying to get the public involved in our science as well.
Science that starts with the shark, but ultimately tells an even bigger picture about the entire ecosystem of our coastal waters. From the University of Southern Mississippi, I'm Layla Essary.